Trooper Brown's death brought election campaigning to a halt, although Labor still is at neck and neck. Bookies have Julia Gillard, the unbackable favourite, with a week to go.
Just a week ago, predicting the election result would have been a coin toss decision, but with it quickly slipping away from Tony Abbott, he was taking advice from all comers. But no help was needed refocusing his campaign, highlighting what he says would happen under a Gillard government.
Every time you turn on the lights, you'll pay. Every time you open the fridge, you'll pay. Australia will be in the hands of the people who executed an elected Prime Minister just because of a dip in the polls.
But it's Mr Abbott's dip that has the pollsters predicting it's now Labor's election to lose. Today's Nielsen poll has Labor opening up a six-point gap to party preferred, with Julia Gillard strengthening her lead as preferred Prime Minister, now holding a 14-point advantage over Mr Abbott. In the marginals, it's much tighter. News poll predicts the coalition could gain 9 seats in Queensland and New South Wales.
I think we are heading towards one of the closest, tightest races in Australia's history.
Keenly aware of their importance, both parties made announcements in marginal seats. The Prime Minister promised a 10-year, $500 million scheme giving farmers credits for reducing and storing carbon.
Good for our world, good for our atmosphere, as we are reducing the amount of carbon, good for farmers.
Mr Abbott committed money for the mining industry.
If Tony Abbott wants to launch a final assault against Labor, well, he won't have much time to sit and rest. Liberal insiders have told 10 News that the party is battling to get enough cash to fund its advertising blitz.
It means he'll have to rely more on stunts such as his asylum seeker truck keeping score of the numbers of boats illegally entering Australian waters. James Boyce, 10 News.
Meantime, a Greens candidate has borne the brunt of angry fishermen at Tweed Heads. The politician wants fishing banned in some areas. The fishermen couldn't contain their fury.
If Greens candidate for Richmond, Joe Obono, thought he might find a sympathetic ear at this morning's protest, he was wrong. Facing an uncertain future, tempers were lost.
They're losing their f***ing houses already and you want to take what they got left.
No, we don't.
And you expect
He was eventually given his marching orders.
Go away! Go away!
It's all over a Labor proposal to impose fishing no-go zones between Fingal Head and Byron Bay, and it's become a hot election issue.
And it's trying to turn it into toilet paper. That's all you can do with it. Wipe the ass on the Greens.
The Greens say it's essential to the longevity of the fishing grounds.
We have to preserve areas where fish breed. We have to preserve the fishing stock.
Sean Spears owns the prawn trawler Carolyn, and he says the science is wrong. The grounds have never been better stocked.
We've just had one of the biggest seasons recorded in 15, 20 years, mate.
He says the move will finish him.
I just don't know where I stand as far as where my livelihood goes.
There are concerns that entire fishing communities like Brunswick Heads and northern New South Wales would be decimated if the fishing no-go zones go ahead.
A petition with hundreds of signatures is to be presented to Peter Garrett pleading for more consultation. The Liberals say if they win power, the plan will be scrapped. Labor MP Justine Elliott was nowhere to be seen. On the Gold Coast, Simon Hooper, 10 News.